the Marvel Cinematic Universe. In recent years, much digital ink has been spilled bemoaning Hollywood's increasing obsession with blockbuster franchise building at the expense of the individual, original films, and it is a troubling platform. There's certainly something lost when studios are more willing to sink hundreds of millions of dollars into one safe family product after another, rather than risk just a few million on another fresh and exciting, just something new in general. But blockbuster franchises have their unique advantages too, and no studio proves that more than with Marvel. Here's a cinematic universe that actually feels like a universe, vast and varied and full of weird corners just waiting to be discovered. When Marvel's firing on all cylinders, the interconnectedness of their films don't feel like limitations, they feel like possibilities. Knowing Ant-Man's running around San Francisco doesn't make it any harder to enjoy Thor's adventures in Asgard, it just makes us more excited to see what will happen if and when they finally meet. Now, while all of Marvel's movies are connected, by virtue of belonging to the same universe and timeline, they're not all intertwined, and this has been a long-going frustration with especially the TV shows and Netflix TV shows. It's quite possible to enjoy Guardians of the Galaxy without ever having seen The Avengers. Heck, you can understand Captain America and Winter Soldier without ever having to watch another movie starring a Captain America. But the reason Marvel feels like a cohesive continuity and a cohesive story is because the individual installments do line up for anyone who cares to look. It's not that every detail has to be perfectly concise and accurate. Marvel's pretty good about sticking to its own internal logic. Contrast this to, say, X-Men Apocalypse, which is both entirely dependent on and completely dismissive of existing continuity. Even if you allow the X-Men Days of Future Past reset, the timeline post-1973, Apocalypse is full of details that don't add up, like the characters' ages. At the same time, Apocalypse depends on our own recollection of previous films to make sense of the characters and the storylines you see before us. Charles' lingering and borderline frustrating concern for Eric makes no sense unless you know that they were best friends in first class, and the Wolverine, Jean Grey scene really only exists as a nod to other installments. Now, while the X-Men has problems beyond its own sloppy plotting, a more rigorous attention to detail would be a good way to start fixing that franchise. Before Iron Man, superhero films were already 7 years into gaining public's goodwill with flicks like Spider-Man, X-Men, and that inexplicable successful Netflix Daredevil movie with playground grappling foreplay. Now, cinematic universes are like crossword puzzles, in that each individual piece has to intersect with the other, and as the narrative expands, it becomes harder and harder to make everything fit, until you give up and play Sudoku like a stupid failure. Just William described teasing out the first Avengers film structure as brutal because how many characters he had to cram in. By Age of Ultron, the number of superpowered people alone jumped from an original 7 to 12 characters blasting along the screen. Whedon called it the hardest work he's ever done. Now, it might sound so crushingly mathematically, but most films out there are structured in the same basic way to make them accessible to the audiences. This usually involves 3 acts with 8 different plot points. Now, moving on to the TV shows, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is apparently constantly fighting a good fight between entertaining an audience and not stepping on the film's toes. The mind-numbingly difficult process is a back and forth where they pitch ideas to Marvel while trying to ration the amount of superheroes they can introduce. After all, what good are the Avengers if the TV show is up to its balls and people who can save the day instead? But a real stinger is Netflix's Daredevil, which both recognizes the world of the Avengers films and the harsh morality of superheroism that Hulk and Black Widow are blessed to ignore. Now this brings us to Infinity War. Undoubtedly the crown jewel of what has been 10 years of hard work and build-up for Marvel, the big hurrah after all the wait. From a distance, a form of a goodbye to at least most characters. I think Marvel is by no means perfect. The cinematic universe, while it was a fine interactive and creative idea, there are many holes in its entirety. Individual films can be seen as filler, villains are now given a ceiling as they must challenge the hero in their current film, but not too much, so if you miss the film, you're not completely lost by the next time you see the character. Also, characters are now confirmed for future movies in advance, removing all tension from their solo film of them being in any form of danger. This puts the Russo brothers in a much more fun position than most directors have had in the past. They don't have the same can't kill him or hurt him too much rule imposed on them. And if the leaked footage is any indication, they're fully aware. All in all, what I take from Marvel as a filmmaker is that to challenge the norm. We have to remember that not everyone was on board when this cinematic universe was first pitched at Comic-Con all those years ago with the first Iron Man. Most were confused, and others wrote them off. However, with the persistence and creative focus on their characters and their goal, they've edged their name into cinematic history, for better or worse. So this film itself is a lot of fun. I've been going about being really busy raising funds for the RP season finale, as is pictured below, we'll see. If you enjoy this film essay, and only if you enjoyed it, and if you want to give back in any way, this is by no means compulsory, to help us make the best season finale we can for you guys. And yeah, let me know what you want to see, because this is all about you. Leave it on the comment show, whether it's a movie, whether it's a TV show, because I'm going to move into TV shows now as well, so make it more broad aspect on the channel. And yeah, you know how this ends. I am Maverick, you're awesome, and we, Maverick Studios. Till next time.